I'm Tiffany Crow and I'm a cancer survivor.
In 2016, I came to the Hermelin Brain Tumor Center because I began having symptoms. My left hand was losing its function, my motor skills were becoming tremendously weak, and I wasn't really sure what was causing that, and so I got an MRI scheduled and saw Dr. Walbert right after just to find out that I had another recurrence and would need a surgery again. So that would be my fourth surgery in 2016.
Unfortunately, brain cancer is very smart, and in most people, the brain tumors do come back.
We are living through one of the most exciting inflection points in the history of cancer and for brain tumors and for neurosurgery in particular. There's never been a more hopeful time. We are literally using space-age technology in the operating room. So neurosurgeons now have the ability to look in real time into a patient's brain and understand the specific tracks that control motor and speech and thought processes, lighting up right next to the approach that we know we're going to have to take to attack a tumor.
By integrating tractography into our normal navigation, what that allows us to do is to select out a more safe corridor to get access to the tumor. Oftentimes the tumor is not right at the surface, most of the time it's actually just below the surface, and you have to pick a pathway to it that causes the least amount of damage to the structures you're trying to protect. And so by seeing these networks of communication, that allows you to then pick out the safest path to get there without disrupting those networks. You know, the goal of surgery is to take out as much tumor as you can safely without causing damage to function. And by having a roadmap for where this function lies, it really does allow you to be as aggressive as you can while also being as safe as you can. So this is the MRI that we use to do Tiffany's surgery. And what we see here is this is the tumor itself, which was selected out in yellow. You can see that this blue fibers, these are actually the motor fibers. Knowing that the motor fibers are actually all around the tumor did change my approach. Normally, if you thought everything was behind, you'd say, well, then I'll come from in front and that'll make it safer. In this case, that would not have been safe. So instead, we did choose to go right on top of it.
Dr. Lee was able to target exactly where he needed to go in and operate. So during that time, they were able to have me assist with functioning and moving my left hand and making sure that they were operating on the correct areas of my brain without harming the healthy cells and losing function in those areas.
We did find that the tumor was really, really tucked into or really pushed into the hand motor area. By really staying very close to the edge of the tumor but not getting into the adjacent brain, we were really able to get almost a complete resection of the tumor, and that actually relieved the pressure on the motor strip on her motor fibers, and subsequently her hand function actually returned almost back to normal.
Tiffany's case is an excellent example how precision medicine and brain tumor therapy on the highest level should work.
I would recommend Henry Ford and the use of their precision medicine and technology to other brain cancer patients because of the success that I've had with it and working with Dr. Lee and Dr. Walbert and all the other staff at Henry Ford. Everybody is great and everyone cares about your quality of life and wants to make sure that you stay happy during this journey and then you have all the support that you need.